Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. I hope that in previous videos you learned a basic of sketcher commands, how we are going to draw the profiles, how we are going to change the dimensions. So today's lecture will cover how we are converting a 2D diagram into a 3D diagram. So for that process we are using this sketch based feature. This is very important toolbar. So let us start our session. Select a sketch plane, then create a circle. We are using this simple command as circle. Give the dimension to this circle, suppose 150 mm, and exit workbench. Then select the pad command here. Pad command. So by using this pad command, you can create. We are just converting our 2D diagram into 3D. So we are providing a thickness to that profile. So this is the thickness, how much thickness we are providing. So give the length is 100 and preview it. So you can see here we are changing the dimension from 50 to 100. Then click on OK button. Okay. So if you want to edit this command again, just double click on the profile. Suppose you want to give the dimensions to another directions or in a reverse direction, so change the mode in reverse direction. Reverse direction, preview, okay. Again, just double click on this same profile. You want to create a 100 mm dimensions on both side of this plane, reference plane. So select here the mirror extend command. Mirror extend preview. So you'll get a 100 mm same to this plane, and this plane is exactly the center to this dimensions. So click on OK button here. Again, you want to change the dimensions. So instead of mirror extend, you want to give the both side dimensions. So there is a more option. Click on the more option. So there is a second length. This is our length 1 and length 2 is given to you. So according to that you can change the dimensions. So look at this. This orange color shows here the length. We are changing the length position here. So this is our first length is 100. Second length is, suppose we are giving here 50. So you can enter here 50. Preview. So this will be our 50. And click on the OK button. So means we can provide two dimensional here. First one is length 1 and second one is length 2. Again click on the same, double click on the same. So if you don't need the second length, so just click on the less and give it to the 100. And before that we need to provide a dimension is 0. And preview. Okay. Again, there is an advanced option for thickness. So we can provide a thick to this element. So click on the thick. So according to our thickness, how much thick elements is required here? So suppose you want to 2 mm thick element. So click 2 mm here and preview. So you can see this is the element whose thickness is 2 mm. And you want to a thickness is second thickness, suppose 5. Again click on the and preview it. So it shows the first thickness is inside and second one is outer side thickness. So that is the difference, that is the thickness 1 and thickness 2. So normally we are using this is the one side thickness, that's 2, and on second side is 0. So click on this, finally click on the OK button. So this is called as your pad command. Now second command is your pocket command. We know that the pocket is nothing but we are removing a material from a block. So for that process again we just have to delete this part. So delete this. Aggregated elements means what sketch we already use for the making of this 3D dimensions. So take on the delete aggregated element here and OK. So our basic sketch should be there. Again give the pad command to this one. Pad suppose 100. Click on OK. Now I want to again remove some material from this block or this cylinder. So we have to create first of all sketch on this periphery or the surface of this cylinder. So select a sketch, then plane. Now I want to create again here one second circle like this one. Give the dimensions to this circle is 30 mm. Now again go to the exit workbench, second command, this is the pocket command. So select the pocket, which profile we have to remove, this profile, then how much material, how much distance we have to remove. So by default it is taking as 100 mm. So 100 mm is what this material should remove throughout this cylinder. So if you want to remove the throughout material, so click on preview button, then you can see here we can easily remove our material, right? And if you want to change the dimension of this one, is suppose you need only a 50 mm depth material is removed, so enter the value of 50 mm here and just go to the preview. So we can remove here the 50 mm. But if you want to again edit this command, again just double click on the same, you can change the value here. So again there is a different types of option. Up to next means what? Again up to last plane is if we are creating another portion behind that part, so that will just take up to this position. Then again there is a up to last. So up to last means throughout. If there are the 10 components are available, so that material will remove from all 10 components. So generally we are using a dimension here. So click on OK button again. Again if you want to make a thick circle here, a thick material here, so click on the thick. How much thickness we need here is a 2 mm by default. So click on preview. So we are just removing a 2 mm thickness of our material, whatever the profile we are providing here. This is the 2 mm thickness. Then if you want to outside dimensions, so you can also give here the 5 mm as the outside dimensions. So look at this, this is the outside dimension is of 5 mm. So look at this, click on the preview. So this is our basic profile, is shown as a white color and orange color. The 2 mm inside is 2 mm. This is our thickness 1 and 5 mm is outside. So from this point to this point is our 5 mm. So if I want to put these values, so click on OK button here. This is called as our pocket command. Now you can normally your general command also use your control Z for our undo. Now again we'll go for our next command. Again next command is our shaft command. So again select a plane, sketcher. I'm just using very simple profile here. This is our spline. I'm using very simple profile. You can easily made a flower plot here by using a spline command. So like this one, then exit workbench. Now we have the next command is shaft command. Select the shaft, which profile, this profile. Now we have to give the axis here. This is the axis is very important here. You can right click on this axis and give the required axis according to our need. We need a Z axis, or instead of that you can directly select this vertical line. Then preview. So look at this. This is called as a shaft command. shaft command. Again, there are the two angles are provided here. First one is our 360 degree and second one is zero. By default 360 is given here because we need a complete revolution of this shaft command here. So click on the OK button here. You want to change the dimensions, again double click on the profile. And suppose I need not a 360, but we need 180 degree revolution of this one. So you just need to click on the preview. So this orange color shows as a 180 degree revolution here. Click on the OK. So we'll get here only a 180 degree revolution of the shaft. Again, you need to convert another values. Again, just double click on the same and give the second angle limit here. So according to that, you can see there is a small changes in the profile. This is our first dimension and this is our second dimension or second angle. According to that, how much we are going to getting our values here. So click on the preview button again. So you'll get the final output. So first angle is 180 degree and second one is 83 degree. You can also change the first angle here like this one. So first angle is suppose 150 degree, preview like this one. So this is called as a shaft command. And generally we are using a 360 degree revolution and here is a zero revolution like this one. Okay. Then again double click on the same profile. You want to create a thick profile. So again give the thickness is how much. Suppose 2 mm. Click on it. Preview. So you'll get here a 2 mm thickness. This completely section is inside because we are providing a 2 mm thickness to this inside sections. So for the viewing of this, you need to click on this wireframe structure. So you can see this is a 2 mm thickness we are creating this. But you need a normal section, so just remove them or untick the thick profile and create a normal. So this is called the shaft command. Now we'll see here the next command is our groove command, and this is very important command. So before starting this groove command, again we need to create some profile here. I'm just selecting this plane. I'm just creating a simple a circle here. Again, just use the dimension here. Suppose dimension is 250 mm. This yellow color indicates here a fit all in, means if your profile is out of the screen, so you just need to click on the fit all in. Exit workbench, convert it to the pad. I'm just using again mirror extend command on the both side 100 mm. Click on the OK. Now I'm just creating another profile here, sketch. Suppose this is the circle. Give the geometrical constraint coincides, then give the dimensions to this circle. There's a 50 mm diameter. Exit workbench. Now we have to use the groove command here. Groove, select this groove command, select this profile, and axis is this one. This is the axis. In groove command, we are removing the material. Again, just click on the preview button, click on OK here. So we are removing the material from the workpiece with the help of this groove command. Again, you want to edit this groove command, just double click on the same profile. Instead of our 360 degree, we just need to remove our material by 180 degree. Then again, click on OK button. So we are just removing our material. This is start point and this is our finish point. So this is total 180 degree. Again, you want to change your dimensions like our first angle and second angle position. So like this one, look at this, we are getting the change in the structure here. We are providing the dimension in first angle and second angle. So first angle is 180 degree and in second angle is 45 degree. So click on the preview button here. Again, okay. Again, there is some advanced option is provided with us, like our thick profile. So click on the thick profile here. How much thickness we need here? Again, by default or 2 mm is given here. Click on preview. So we'll get here a 2 mm thickness of our material here. We're just removing the 2 mm thick material. Yes. We're increasing the value 3 mm, 4 mm, 5 mm. So you can clearly observe it. So look at this. This is 5 mm thickness material we are removing from the same component. So this is called as a groove command. This is called as a groove command. Now next command is a hole command. So normally we know that we need to create our hole here. So select a hole here, and on which profile we need to create our hole. So select this profile. Now take a point where you need. So by default it is exactly on the center. How much diameter is required here? A 10 mm. We are just putting a 50 mm diameter. How much depth is required here? Again, suppose 50 mm. And or you can give a different type of options, up to next, up to last, up to, so like that one. And create a preview here. So we are just creating this hole here. Again, there are different types of holes are available with us. So again, to modify this hole, again we need to double click on the same. So there are different types of holes are provided here. First one is simple, second one is tapered. So how much tapered we required here? So for the tapered, we need to provide the degree in the degree or angle of that hole. So by default it is 90 degree, we are just providing as a 45 degree. So look at this. So this will be a 45 degree. Click on the OK button, so we'll get this 45 degree inclination here. Again, click on the same. You need to change the type. Instead of tapered, a counter bore. So the structure is also shown here, counter bore. So counter bore, again there are the two different types of holes here. This is our first hole and this is our second hole. So by default our first hole diameter is our 50 mm and second parameter is a 50. So instead of that 50, we'll just provide a 75 and the depth is 5 mm. So you can see here a preview. So like this one. So this is our next type of hole. So by using this hole command, you can create a different types of hole profile here. This is called as a hole. Again, click on the same command. So there is a thread definition is also provided here. You can also create a thread here. So according to that, basically the requirement of our thread is a pitch size. So we need to provide here the pitch. How much mm is pitch according to our requirement. So that is the basic requirement here. So this is related to our hole command. Now the next command is our rib command, and this is also a very important command. I just delete this. So we'll see here a rib command. Now again, select a plane, make it a simple sketch. I'm using a very simple sketch here. Exit workbench, give the pad command to this one. Mirror extend, suppose I'm just using a 50 mm mirror extend. Then again, now I'm using a simple sketch here. I'm using a spline here. So this is the start point, second, like this one. like exit workbench. Now I'm creating a simple structure here like this one, exit workbench. Now our next command is our reap command and a slot command. So you'll see the both application here. So reap command, so again select the reap command here, which profile we need to reap, this profile, and this is the center curve. So select the center. So what will happen this one? So this will create here a additional material. We are adding a material here like this one. This is our reap command. This is our reap command. Means what? We are adding a material here. Click on the reap command. Merge ends. Like this one. This is our reap command. This is our reap command. Now let's see the second command. Second one is our slot command. We know that again the slot, we have to select this profile and this is the path. Click on the preview button. Okay. So we are just removing the material through the same path. That is called the slot command. So this is related to our sketch based feature toolbar. This is very important toolbar. We are converting a 2D into 3D with the help of this sketch toolbar. I hope that this session will help you to convert a part profile, that 2D part into a 3D part. So I'll end this session up to this, and in next lecture we'll see again some advanced or modification toolbar in part modeling. So I hope that you learn a very basic concept of our CATIA by this channel. So if you like my channel, please kindly subscribe and share with all needy people, so those who can learn this CATIA software. So there is no need to go for the extra coaching classes. So I hope that this is okay. So thank you.